I like to think of resilience as being able to be captured in a framework that includes the seven C's. The seven C's are masterfully stolen from the positive youth development movement, which has five of the C's. What are those C's? The first thing we need is confidence, right? We're gonna be resilient, we're gonna be able to bounce back if we believe we can. We knew for 20 years how to build confidence in kids. It was give them self-esteem. That's why we had kids draw out pictures of butterflies in kindergarten. All the butterflies went on the wall. And then we said to the kids, each of you, you're as special as a butterfly. Lesson two was we would cut out snowflakes and they would go out on the wall. And the lesson to the kids was, each of you, you're as unique as a snowflake. We taught parents to praise absolutely everything that their children did. We applauded as the kids came down on the sliding board saying, good job, good job, good job, never giving any credit at all to gravity. What happened? By raising kids with just showering them with self-esteem, they ended up having very high rates of anxiety and even depression. What's going on? Do you ever have those moments where you don't feel as special as a butterfly? We didn't prepare kids to know how to deal with those moments. Real confidence comes not from people showering vapid praise on you. Real confidence comes from your internal sense of competence, knowing that you have skills, knowing that you have abilities, and having adults help you to develop those abilities, have adults see those abilities in you, and above all, have adults not undermine those abilities by telling you what you are or not capable of. The next C is connection. Bottom line is that the kids who are going to make it are the kids who know that someone has their back. Better if there are circles around them of multiple adults who have their back. That's what's going to give them the confidence to be able to take chances. But up until now, if we look at the first three C's, kids who are really confident, kids who are really competent, kids who are really connected, you've described a gang member. So what else do you need? You need character, a sense of what is right and a sense of what is wrong. You need character, grit, tenacity, being able to stick with things. What else do you need? A sense of contribution, knowing that you're making a difference in the world. Why? The ultimate act of resilience during the worst of times is to reach out to another human being and say, brother, I need a hand. What is going to allow you to do that without shame or stigma? It's the experience of having served. When you serve, when you give, you learn something. You learn that it feels good. And when you know that it feels good, it's easier to take when you need to take. So when I'm an old man and someone is changing me or feeding me, I'll know that there's not pity in the room, just another human being who also has a life mission to serve. But it's more than that. Teenagers are held to low expectations. All teenagers walk down the street and people think they're selfish, self-involved, at risk. That doesn't even begin to describe the low expectations that we hold our oppressed minority kids to. It is poison. And there, because resilience kids live up or down to your expectations of them, we simply have to turn the ship around. So when we have kids contributing out in the community, what happens? Suddenly these same kids who normally we walk past and look as if they're dangerous, suddenly those kids are receiving thank yous instead of condemnation. And it's difficult to describe how important it is for kids to know how much they matter to other people. And you learn that through thank yous. And you get thank yous through contribution. Next, coping. You know, virtually everything we fear in adolescence is about kids trying to feel better in the context of a life that feels uncomfortable. Whether you're talking about drugs, whether you're talking about cutting, whether you're talking about eating disorders, whether you're talking about fighting, whether you're talking about gaming, everything, sex out of the context of a relationship, everything we fear, everything we don't want our kids to do is about them trying to feel better. And when we say to them, don't do that, let me give you 5 to 7 reasons why you should know what you're doing is wrong, that just makes them feel small. It takes away their confidence because we're calling them incompetent. Instead, when we congratulate them for finding something, anything that works, and then we invite them in a healing process to teach them a whole repertoire of positive coping strategies, then we can really diminish risk behaviors. But why wait till kids are already doing it? Why not start with kids in nursery school kids in kindergarten. Teach them about all the ways you can feel better. Teach them about all the ways you can manage stress. If we do that, that's when we're going to really see some of these problem behaviors go away. The final C is control. You either believe that the world happens to you, or you believe you have control over your universe. Dr. Ken, when your time comes, you know, bullets are flying. That's a kid who doesn't believe they have a sense of control over their life, and they'll take control in any way that they can. Where do we give kids a sense of control? First off, we stop the bullets from flying. What else do? We teach them discipline. Remember what discipline means. Discipline means to teach. It doesn't mean to punish. It doesn't mean to harm. And it doesn't mean to control. When we discipline kids, instead of saying, you'll do what I say, why? Because I said so. That makes kids feel small. When instead we discipline them saying, you know, we honor your growing independence. We want you to know how to stand on your own and to navigate these waters you're on your own. We want that. But we need for you to be safe and need to be responsible. So the privileges that we are going to give you, the freedoms that you have, will be earned by your demonstrated responsibility and good behavior. When we do that, kids do the right thing because they are in control of their behavior.